Okay, so I'm going to show you how to create a free account in Eduhero and log in for the first time. What you first want to do is go to www.eduhero.net in your web browser. We do recommend using Google Chrome as your web browser. It is the fastest and plays courses without any issues. Now, when you get to this page, you can log in or just click Create a Free Account at the bottom. Once you get here, it wants your email address and password. Now, I'm just going to simply use a Hotmail account I have, and go with a simple password for testing purposes. And I will say that some emails get filtered out based on your school email client. Now, it's best if you whitelist ESC6.net at your district, and that way you won't miss this authentication email, which is required to create an account. Now, also, you want to use your district email to register this account. That is because if you use your district email, it's what will grant you access to take courses. So do not use your personal email address unless you're like a substitute teacher and you just don't have a district email. Now I'm going to click Create Account near the bottom, and it informs me I should check my email to confirm the account. Also check junk mail folders, it could end up in there. So I'm going to go over to hotmail.com and type in my login. And what do you know? There's my Welcome to Eduhero email, which is a good thing. So I'm going to click that, and you can see here it's telling me my password to log in again, which is password 1, and it gives me a link to follow to confirm my account. Go ahead, click that. So it says account confirmed. Please close any other browser windows and log in. What that is like if you have another Eduhero browser window like I do, close that out and then log in. It's best to run Eduhero in one single browser window. So I'm going to go ahead. Now I can log in with that account I just created with the password provided in that email and click login. And so there it is. I received a subscription to the custom course package. If so, that's fine. You can view the package here, but I'm going to just close that. Now, when you first log in, there's some basic account setup steps. It wants your name and year born. It is best to provide this because this is your account. You want it to be an authentic account. So click continue. Second step is what city I'm born in. This is a security question. So if you have issues logging in, you can use this security question. I'm just gonna make one up and continue. And this is trying to verify my state and my occupation. This stuff is not required, so you could skip this step. But I do recommend filling this in regardless. It helps your profile be updated. And your administrators can have a better idea of who you are, where you work, and all that. So you can set up an alternate email. This is used for account recovery if you have issues logging in. I'm just going to leave it blank, continue. And this is more of a fun step. Like this helps us find what you're looking for in Eduhero. So for me, I'm just looking for free courses, so I'm going to click that and hit continue. And this last step of five steps, you can create an avatar. And this is really just a fun step. You can select an avatar here or skip it. Level 1 rewards, level 2 rewards. So if you level up, you can unlock more avatars. That's based on how many courses you take. So I'm just going to click that one, and you can see it updates, and I'm good to go. Once you do that, go back to the home page, and it's informing me you can always view popular and recommended courses from the home page. I'm going to click continue. And that's about it for the tutorials. If you start clicking around these other places like learning, Yeah, you'll see more tutorials, and so you just hit continue, and that is the only time you'll see these tutorials. So it is best to read through them, try to understand Eduhero, its navigation, and the robust power it can provide. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and good luck on registering.